So hi, and previously what we did was introduction, and we did the concept of fit and hit. Now the concept of fit and hit will be used in dilation, erosion, then opening, closing, right? So that was just the operations. Now that is not like that can't perform morphological image processing, or you can say we don't give them a term. Now we'll see some of the two fundamental operations of morphological image processing today, which are erosion and dilation, right? So fundamentally, the morphological image processing is very much like spatial filtering, right? You have seen now already. The structuring element is moved across every pixel in the original image to give a pixel in the new processed image, and what is the value of the new pixel will be depending upon what is the operation you're going to perform, like whether it's a hit or it's a fit operation. So definitely the pixel value will change depending upon the operation you perform. Now the two basic morphological operations which we have are erosion and dilation. Now what is this erosion and dilation? Now I have summarized it. Erosion, dilation. Basically, when you're doing a fit, you call it as erosion. And whenever you are doing a hit, you call it as dilation. So this is just a fancy term which we have given. Now you might be thinking that, wait, why are we not calling it fit and hit only? If we are performing the fit operation, why are we calling it as erosion? Just because we'll be using fit and hit in opening and closing as well. So we just make it a term just to avoid confusion, right? So erosion is also nothing but it is a fit operation, and dilation is nothing but a hit operation. Now, why erosion is a fit and dilation is a hit? Definitely, if your English is good, you would be knowing this. Erosion. We have heard of this term erosion. Erosion means to erode. Erode means to reduce something. Like we have heard of soil erosion when we were small, right? In 8th or 9th class, we did erosion, or even before that. So what happens in soil erosion? The upper layer gets removed, or rather than upper layer, I'm doing MIP. So I can say some layer gets removed. And what is dilation? You just fill something up, right? So that is the reason we say that erosion means fit. Because in fit, generally what happens is that you reduce something, you reduce the size. Why? Because if you are not getting all the on pixels of structuring element covering up the all the on pixels of the image, definitely it's not going to, work. It will work only if all the on pixels will overlap all the on pixels. If not, it won't matter, right? So that is reason we call it erosion, because it is reducing, and it is because it is reducing, so it is kind of thinning, right? You thin out something. Now dilation will be a hit, and you are kind of increasing, because even if you get one on pixel of the structuring element matching with one on pixel, that is going to be a hit, and that is the reason I call it as dilation, and it will lead to increasing, and this is kind of thickening. Now, how we represent it? We represent erosion as F, then a minus with a circle S. How we read it? We read erosion of image F by structuring element S. Similarly, we read this is a plus with a, you can say inside a circle, we say dilation of image F by a structuring element S, right? Now, if I have to write it mathematically, that erosion is a fit and dilation is a hit, I'll write now g x comma y, just take it as the new image or the processed image, like image after MIP. It will be 1 if s fits f, 0 otherwise. It is 1 if s hits f and 0 otherwise. Now, you'll be more clear with the example, right? Now, I just say that, okay, supposedly this is my original image, and again I'm saying that dark blue, consider it as my 1, and light blue, consider it as my 0. So here also this is 1 and this is 0. There's some color variation, but yeah, this color is same as this color, right? Now you're supposed to place this structuring element over here. When you will just go on and on and on, you'll see that this is the image you get. Now, what does this green portion means? Green portion means that this where it was blue initially, it has been removed due to erosion. Now, how? Now, I'll not explain you how this whole image came. I'll just explain you with respect to this pixel and this pixel. Later on, pause the video and see how it came, right? Now, supposedly this is the pixel on which I am going to keep my structuring element. And if it is so, my structuring element would be something like this. It will be a plus over here. It will be the blue portions at this point, this point, this point, and this point. So here, if it's a plus, according to erosion, it should be a fit. If it is to be a fit, all the on pixels must match. This on pixel match, this on pixel match, but this on pixel doesn't match. Even this on pixel doesn't match. So what happens is that here it will be light blue, right? It will be light blue, but why I have shown it through green? So that you know that this part is removed now. It's not now dark blue over here. Now let's just move on to next, which is this. Here, if you try to keep a plus, no, rest are don't cares, right? Totally doesn't matter. Here, all the on pixels are matching. If all the on pixels are matching, so it's also gonna be blue, which is one. So this is how the erosion takes place. Similarly, you can do for dilation. Again, let me just take an example of this and this now, right? So if you have this, definitely you'll be doing padding, right? So I assume that you do padding with boundary pixels, and boundary pixels are zero. So here it also will be zero. Zero, 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 but here it's one. At least one on pixel matches, and in dilation we look for a hit. So for this pixel, it's a hit. So it will be dark blue over here. Now here, why I'm showing the this green areas? These green areas signify the new pixel is added, right? So now it is dark blue, right? So wherever it is green in the previous in erosion, wherever it was green, it was light blue. But here, wherever it is green, it will be what? It will be my dark blue. So this is just I have shown you so that you may know, right? Okay, now let's take this pixel. Here also, this is already blue, itself blue, so it is definitely gonna be a hit. So do you just observe one thing? We just saw that how the size reduced in erosion and how the size expanded in dilation. That is the significance of erosion and dilation, right? Okay, now let's just see one more example to be more clear about this erosion and dilation. So this is erosion. This is my original image. Say I apply 3x3 structuring element. It is a bit, thinning happened, right? Here a lot thinning happened. Now why? Because I used 5x5 structuring element. So definitely 5x5 structuring element will make it more precise, right? Okay, one thing you will think, and there will be one confusion which you may be thinking about, that wait, black is zero, right? If black is zero, then how erosion is taking place? Actually, here in these examples, black is referred to as one. Yeah, it might appear strange to you, but yeah, we are is like just to show you, right? I'm just saying that okay, black is one over here. Like here the background is white. It can happen, right? So you can code MATLAB in such a way that you represent one with a black and zero with a white, but this is not a part of this lecture sequence. Now next, let's see an example of dilation. This is the original image. After you perform dilation by 3x3, it's a bit, more thickened. Then by 5x5, it is more thickened. And here also one is referred to as black pixel. Okay, let's just take more example of erosion. This is the original image. Now here I'm using the structuring element which is of a shape of a disc of radius 10. Now if disc has a shape of radius 10, which means in a row there will be total 20 pixels, which means it is possibly a 20 cross 20 structuring element, right? So if you provide that, you will see that all these features are gone and these all are thin. Even this is thin. But if you apply it with the less radius, which is radius 5, you just see that it is less thinner than this. And this features are still there. But if you use more radius, which is 20, then this is what you obtain. Now, why is it so? Because if you increase the size of structuring element, then it means more on pixels, and it means more on pixels should match the on pixels of your image, right? So that is the reason we are not getting over here the other pixels. Now let's just see that where dilation is used, right? Now you might have used cam scanner, right? We use it everywhere. I don't say that cam scanner is using the exact same thing, which is dilation, but somewhat this, right? If you just see that this was my original image, and this is after dilation I performed. Here E and A were somewhat like this, and after I applied this structuring element, which is a very simple structuring element, this is how it works. Like, now you might be thinking that, are the things so easy? Yeah, even you can also make some application like cam scanner, where you can perform dilation on the captured nodes, right? You can make a small, you can say small application where you apply dilation, and if you, whatever text you have, you'll have it a bit bold text, and this is more readable than this, right? So this is so easy to develop something, right? You have to just apply the concepts into your real life. That's all you're supposed to do, right? Now we'll see that specifically where we use erosion and specifically where we use dilation, right? So in erosion, we use when we are supposed to split apart some joint objects, right? How it will be split apart? Because this will be thinned, right? This will also be thinned. If both are thinned, so what happens is that here you'll be having a space. Next is that erosion can strip away any extrusion if it is there, right? So it is shrinking your object. And what will dilation do? Dilation will do the opposite thing. Here it is splitting apart the joint objects. There, what it will do if there is any break, it will repair that break. Opposite to erosion, right? There it was stripping away any extrusion. Here it is repairing any intrusion. What erosion did? It shrink the object. Dilation is going to enlarge your object, right? So let's conclude what we started till now. For the basic morphological operators, the structuring element contains only foreground pixels, that is ones, and don't cares or zeros for the rest, right? Definitely, I said whatever shape you want, you just make one over there, right? That is what I talked about in some lecture one or lecture two, I don't remember. So these operators, which are a combination of erosion and dilution, they can be used to select or suppress a feature of certain shape. Now, definitely what we did was, like here if you see, right? Here what you did, you suppressed some feature, this, right? Here what you did, you selected a feature. So, depending upon what you want, what we do is we select or suppress the feature of a certain shape. And the most general operator is hit and miss. In fact, all the morphological operators can be deduced from it. Now we'll be seeing opening and closing. There also I'll be using hit and miss again, or hit and fit, sorry, right? So that's some other term we give to fit as well. Its variations are often used to simplify the representation of an object while preserving their structure. For example, producing the skeleton of an object using skeletization or tidying up the results during thinning. Now, what does it mean? It says that in MIP, these operators help me a lot. How they help me? Supposedly, I'm supposed to represent some object, right? And during the representations, sometimes it happens that some pixel value goes wrong. And if it is so, how will I repair it? How will I improve it? I just go for MIP. It will tidy up the results through thinning. Okay, now this is the image which you have. This is the original image. If I apply erosion on this image, this is what I will get. If I apply dilation on this image, this is what I get. But if you just see that erosion alone is not giving me very good results, right? Possible that I want this only, yeah. But what if I want that these features should also be there? I thought that, okay, if I want these features to be there, I should go for dilation. But in dilation, what happens? This is also black. So it means that in some places erosion is working good, in some places dilation is working good. Shouldn't we combine it to get the results? Like,